What the issue is in? We'll talk about steps of the visa process. Visa process steps.
It's important, this one. They are on this YouTube.
This one? This YouTube? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes. I guess they're recording.
And then I will send to students. Is it okay? We can start. So, hello, welcome to our webinar on these issues. I'm Pavlina Pavlova from the International Student Services Office, and this is Viktor Draganov. We both work in this office and are here to help you with getting ready for the visa. So we will talk a little bit about the steps of this process, and then you can ask your questions. So the first thing you have to do is to read the visa letter that you will receive or you have already received from admissions office. Read this visa letter carefully because it gives you all the steps that you follow to prepare your visa. So the first step is to prepare documents that you have to send to our office. So these documents are a copy of your high school diploma with the grades from the year studied at high school, another document that gives you the right to continue your education, the third document, medical certificate. All these three documents should have Bulgarian translation, and according to the country, the translation and legalization requirements are different. And two more things, two passport size photos and a copy of your international passport. So the last two are very easy to prepare. About the passport, just make sure it has validity of 18 months, a year and a half. Then after you send all these documents to us, very important is to know that you have to send all the documents at once. So you have to send all the documents. Don't skip any of the documents listed in this first part of the visa letter. Send all the documents at once. After we receive them, we forward them to the Ministry of Education. Then you'll get the certificate from that ministry and from us. And the next step, you'll receive all these documents and you have to apply for the visa. While waiting for the documents from us, you can prepare the other documents required by the embassy. There is a question from Ukraine. In Ukraine, the diplomas obtained about the end of June, and most probably the students will not be able to translate and send them to ABG by the deadline that we have given in the visa letter, so don't worry about that. We know that it takes time to go through this legalization translation process, but try to do that as soon as possible. And then on each of the further steps, we try our best to speed up the process. And usually students receive their visas on time. So just get your diploma, do all the documents the way they are required in the visa steps and send them to us. Don't be kind of scared and panicked that you will not get the visa on time. So, any other questions? We will. I replied. So now it's the time to, as I said, to read the visa letter carefully. And while you're waiting for your diplomas to be issued, you can contact us if you have some questions. And now we have a question from an American student, Carly Morris. I guess she is completing the application form for visa. And there's a question there, what is the expected intended date of arrival and departure? Yeah, you can write August 2017. The orientation starts August 20?
August 31st.
So the orientation starts August 31st. This means that
you can come 2 days prior to that, no earlier than that.
So you can put as an intended date of departure about 30th of August 29th, and then May 2018, about 15th of May, between 15th and 20th, you'll be done with your final exams and you can leave. By the way, Carly, we sent your documents today, so DHL will deliver them to you shortly. So please apply for your visa immediately after you receive the documents from us. So as I said, it's very important to follow exactly the requirements given in the visa letter. Don't listen to your friends who attended ABG 8 years ago or anybody else. You might hear advice like, oh, 8 years ago we didn't need to make legalized translation, we didn't need this document. This year, the ministries, Ministry of Education, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, they all are applying the regulations very strictly, no exceptions. So we advise the new students to follow the instructions strictly. Otherwise, they waste time and money, and at the end, they do the things the way they are required, but after wasting some time and money. Don't translate the documents into English. We have received some documents translated into English and now we are giving them for Bulgarian translations. Translation. The documents in the first part of the visa letter, they must have Bulgarian translation. If the in the Bulgarian translation must be certified by the Bulgarian embassy in that country. If there is no Bulgarian embassy in your country, or the Bulgarian embassy in your country does not provide certified translation, contact us so that we do this certified translation here in Bulgaria. And it is very important to check whether the requirements for your country, whether the documents need apostille, whether they don't, or whether if you're from Nepal or Bangladesh, for example, there are some additional certifications. So, as I said, read the visa letter carefully, and then if something is unclear, contact us. If you're not sure whether you have the right documents, scan the documents, send them to us, to Viktor or to me. We'll confirm, yes, send them by email first before mailing them as hard copies. We'll see the scanned copies. If we need to discuss them with the Ministry of Education in Sofia, we'll do that. And that will kind of prevent from mistakes. Carly has some questions about completing the application form, which gives me an idea that we can post a link with a sample how to complete that form. But for now, she has a question about inviting person. Who's the contact person for anything? Not the person I met. So the inviting person, you put AUVG, and the inviting person and inviting organization, it's one and the same, it's AUVG. And as a contact person, you can put my name or Victor's name. And the next question is about personal data of a family member who is EU, citizen. If you don't have such a family member, just put not applicable. If you're not sure how to complete something, how to fill in something in this application form, leave it blank.
Because I think that when you go to the embassy or the consulate, if you need to fill out something additional, they'll tell you and you can do it on the spot.
Yeah, that's good. While we're waiting for more questions, I want to underline that everybody needs the document about continuing education. Sometimes students are kind of worried that they cannot obtain this document, but from experience we know that either schools or educational departments in your hometown or country, they issue this document. This is a very, very simple document with a very simple information that you have the right to continue your education in a high institution. Just follow the links that we have given in the visa letter to prepare this document and the medical certificate. So there are two certificates, medical certificates that you will need. So the first one, on the first step, is the medical certificate for visa purposes. You have the link in the visa letter. It's again a very simple a document stating that you're in a good mental and physical health, which allows you to study in the university. There is no need of blood tests and other immunization records and anything else. On a later stage, you will need to complete a health certificate sent to you by the AUVG Health Center, and then you have to consult your doctor about immunization records and other stuff. But for the visa purposes, there is no form, just a simple document that you are healthy.
Okay, so we have another question now. Do I have to apply for the visa in person, or I can send the documents? For the visa type D, you have to apply in person. That's a requirement of the embassies, and you cannot just send your passport and receive the visa if you're not there. So.
Yeah, and one more advice. Before you go to the embassy, it doesn't matter in which country you are, contact them to make sure that you have all the documents. Because sometimes you plan a long trip to the Bulgarian consulate to submit your visa application, and it might happen that you miss something. So we recommend that you check all the documents that you have prepared for the visa application with the Bulgarian consulate before you go there. And in the US, I think that you can arrange with the consulate to receive the passport with the visa, but you have to apply in person. There are no exceptions. So, is there anything that you want to?
So, we're open to more questions. Don't feel shy, go ahead now. I know that you have some questions. If you come up with any questions after this webinar, you can always write to us.
And the first stage is very important. There is nothing you can do before you get the diploma, but you can prepare the other documents. And you can get the information how to get stamps. For example, if you're from Albania, you need a stamp called apostille. So you can see how you can get that, how long it will take to get that apostille. You can get the information on the Bulgarian translators. So be ready at the moment you receive your high school diploma to do immediately the certified translation. And on this stage, the medical certificate is something that also needs to be with certified translation. So that takes some time too. When you have all the documents and you send them to us, while you're waiting, you can start completing the application form, preparing the other documents, approve that you have enough money to live in Bulgaria. That can be a bank certificate, a declaration from your parents. You have to check that with the consulate because different countries kind of have different requirements. And a very important document for your visa application while you're waiting for us to send you the certificates. Those who are 18 or above, they need police clearance report. Those who are under 18, they need a declaration from parents that you can travel to Bulgaria and then apply for a residence permit. So you can work on these documents too. These two documents, you do not need to send them to us. You need them for the visa application. And one important thing, make copies of all the documents that you submit to the embassy. And make sure you get back the police report, the original police report and the original declaration, if you are 18, because this will be a document for your Bulgarian ID card application later. So for now, remember that when you get the passport with the visa, you should get back the police report if you are above, or the declaration from parents if you are under 18. You see, they all see these steps?
So this is a graph with the visa process, the steps. We made it in a more visually appealing way. It's shorter. We'll put it on the website as well. Basically, it describes everything we've spoken so far, how you have to read the visa letter, you have to wait for your diplomas,
Then you send us the documents. After you send us the documents, we'll send them to the Ministry of Education. It usually takes them about 2 weeks to issue a certificate that you later need for the visa application. Basically, this is the process in the Ministry of Education. After we get the certificate, we'll send it to you together with some other AUPG issued documents, and then with these documents and the ones you've prepared, like application form and the police report, you apply for a visa at the embassy. And as you see, this is the whole process after you apply for the visa. It's rather long, it usually takes about 1 month. That's why we are saying that you have to be quick on every step. So yeah, as I said, we'll put this on the website so you can read.
Speaking of the long process through which the documents, the visa application goes, I want to warn something. Most probably when you submit your visa application, you will be told you'll get the visa middle of September. Or sometimes you'll hear it takes 2 months, you'll get the visa end of September. So don't panic. Just keep us updated on anything that you do. When you apply for the visa, let us know when. If there is a delay of something, send us an email to see if we can help from here. So the embassy receives the visa application. The embassy gives you back the passport with the visa. But in between these two ends, so the beginning and the end, there are about five authorities included, which are located in Bulgaria, Sofia and Lvov. We are in touch with them, and when there is a problem, we contact them. Not everything is under our control, but so far, from our experience, when the visa application is with perfect documents and there are no objections for the visa to be issued, our students get their visas and then come on time. When you arrive in Sofia, if you need some help in transferring from Sofia Airport to Blagoevgrad to the residence hall, we can help you with that. There are ABG vans who can pick you up from Sofia Airport and bring you to Blagoevgrad. So when you have the dates and time of the date and time of departure in Sofia, please contact us and we'll direct you to the right office who can arrange this transfer from the airport. Can we see if we have some questions? So don't be shy to contact us. Don't think that you have stupid questions. There is no stupid question. The process looks very complicated, but it is doable. We've been doing that for many years. And sometimes a little bit more difficult for some countries, but everybody in the university, in these authorities, is kind of helpful. So although it takes time for all these institutions to approve the visa, we try our best and students come. So more questions?
For now.
When you complete the application form, you apply for multiple visa, 180 days, which is 6 months. This means that with this visa, you enter Bulgaria and stay legally up to 6 months. Before it expires, you will apply for a residence permit, but when you come, there will be international student orientation session and we'll give you all the instructions how to do that, explain the deadlines, fees, and everything. If you're from neighboring countries like Macedonia, Albania, Serbia, and you haven't received your visa, you can come with your passport, start studying at AVG, and then go back during the fall break to pick up the visa. Recently, citizens from Ukraine can also come to Ukraine and Georgia. They can also come to Bulgaria without visa, stay up to 90 days. But coming without visa does not mean that you can stay like that. So that's a kind of a backup plan in the worst scenario when the visa has been delayed. But we strongly recommend that even in such cases, you have to apply for the visa. Even it looks like you will not get the visa, you have to apply. And once again, this is for countries which are allowed, citizens are allowed to come to Bulgaria as tourists for up to 90 days. But try your best to apply and get the visa. When is the earliest time I can arrive at the campus? 2 days before the orientation starts, which means 28th, 29th of August. So for all questions regarding your housing, you can contact our colleagues from Residence Life. If you go to the AVG website, you'll find Residence Life and you'll see all the contact information there. The director of Residence Life department is Todor Kehayov. His email is todor@avg.edu. So if you have any questions or concerns about your room assignment, what to bring to your room, you can contact them.
Also, we will prepare a webinar about Residence Life.
Oh, my colleague Viktor from admissions office reminded me that there will be another webinar with the colleagues from Residence Life, so you will get information about residing in the residence halls from them, which is great. Regarding buying the plane tickets, I know it's better to book and buy the tickets in advance, but don't be in a hurry to buy the ticket, because you have to see how the visa will work. Sometimes if you apply very late, it might happen that you kind of miss 1 or 2 days of the orientation. So until you have pre-information when you get the visa, don't be in a hurry to pay for the ticket. So can you upload the visa decision?
Yes,
we'll do that. Judging from your name, I guess you're from Mongolia. Unfortunately, it's very difficult for the students from Mongolia because they have to go to Beijing to apply for the visa and then to go and get it. Unfortunately, as I said, there are no exceptions. The visa application must be submitted in person. Any other questions? So I would say that the highlight of the process is don't translate the documents into English. Translate them with a certified translation by the Bulgarian embassy. In your country, if that's not possible, send them to us. And don't skip any document from the list in the visa letter, because it will not work. Even if you send 3 instead of 5 documents, we cannot proceed them. If we send them to the Ministry of Education, they will be returned to us. If there's only 1 document missing, the Ministry of Education does not issue the visa certificate. So maybe for the 3rd or 4th time, don't skip any step given in the visa letter. Viktor, did I leave anything?
Nothing to think of.
So, although it's summer, our office will not close. We take turns in taking vacations, and in July and August, we usually don't take more than 2-3 days. So, we are here to help you. And feel free to contact us anytime you have a question, you feel frustrated, or you are hesitating about something. If you're not sure how to do things, contact us. We're very pleased that we have students who contact us every day. Sometimes that's better, rather than making a mistake. Our colleague from admissions is a magician. It took him a second to put the his information on Facebook. So that's kind of a general information on the visa process. Each of you have received or will receive a visa letter. We designed the visa letter according to the country you come from. Yes, you apply at the Bulgarian embassy, and you might think that all the requirements should be the same for everybody, but Bulgaria and your country has some agreements. So Bulgaria has one agreement with Mongolia, another agreement with Albania. That's why the visa letter is designed especially for you according to the country you come from.
I see that there are no questions. Maybe you guys already know everything, which is okay with us, you know. But if you think of something, don't feel shy. That's why we're here for. So.
Yeah, both Viktor and I are experienced in doing that, so we will help you on this long journey to the embassy. So it is not possible for us to check how it works with each embassy, whether you need to make an appointment in advance. So that's something that you can do while waiting for the diploma to be issued. So just use the time to get information until you have the diploma. Because as I said, until you have the diploma, you can't send any documents to us. But you can collect the right information so that you do the things in a timely manner and the right way.
And also, as Polly said, you can contact the embassies. Lately, from our experience, they're pretty helpful, so you can gather information from them as well.
In many countries, they are used to have students from AUBG applying for visa there. And they usually say that AFG students go with perfect documents, which makes their job easier. But as I said, after you submit the documents to the embassy, there are other institutions involved. They take the decision on the visa. And that's why it's a little bit time consuming. You know, bureaucracy is everywhere, so I guess we can't change that. But if you from your side and here, AFG from our side, do things immediately in a timely manner. Everything is doable. So once you have the visa, you'll be kind of relieved. You can start packing. Now I'm sure that it seems like it will be another century because you have to do a lot of things until then. But yeah, at some point you have to do that, and you'll like it.
Also, one more thing. Usually, don't advise students to buy plane tickets before they get their visas. I know that sometimes this may not be possible from the end of the summer in the beginning of the orientation. But if you have that possibility, get the visa first and then purchase plane tickets.
Last chance for questions.
So we'll give you 5 more minutes if somebody else shows up and ask questions. And sometimes parents of new students are willing to come. We do not provide assistance, visa assistance to parents. We help students. We don't have parents, but in most of the countries there are agencies who do that, which do that. And your parents will come with a tourist visa, and getting a tourist visa is much, much easier and faster than your student visa. So they should just contact the embassy, ask for the documents for C visa, and they'll be fine. Another advice we give to students when they, now that we're done with the visa, we can talk about other issues. When they come to Sofia Airport and they need Bulgarian money, we advise that you don't exchange money at Sofia Airport because the exchange rate is low. There are a lot of exchange bureaus in Novograd. It's full of ATM machines, so you can use your debit card from the bank in your home country. In Bulgaria, of course, there'll be some charges depending on the bank, but you have an option. Okay, I guess.
So if you don't have any more questions, I suggest to stop here. We hope that this webinar was helpful to you, and if you have further questions, feel free to contact us. You can see our email address on the AUBG website, on the internet, and in the visa letter as well, yes.
Okay, good luck in preparing the documents. We'll be waiting for these documents to come as soon as possible. The sooner the better. Mm-hmm. Ciao.
Bye.
We'll be waiting for your questions, documents, everything.